Are there any basics that you would think in terms of the schedule itself? So daily, weekly, monthly, you know, in terms of time and frequency. I've interviewed a lot of people, and there's always differences, and there's differences for a reason. But one of the things people sort of say to me is, well, how many times a week should I work out? And, you know, should I work out in the morning or evening? And in a month, should I, you know, should I sort of have a week off every now and again? So are there some things that you've just, again, generic stuff you found is generally successful in terms of that regularity and frequency?
Yeah, I call it the 7 habits of highly healthy people. And I don't want to misquote myself here, so I'm actually looking it up so I can say it correctly. But the first one is strength training. 2 to 3 days a week of progressive strength training is going to be the cornerstone of that program. 3 to 4 days per week of cardiovascular-based training is going to add a lot of benefit for most people. From there, you're looking at trying to move your body mindfully every single hour, no matter where you are. Sleeping is the exception. Don't get up every hour to move while you're sleeping. But being able to stand up from your desk to reset your postures and get into a different position if you can. Your best posture and your best position is your next position, keeping that in mind. Looking at investing just 10 minutes a day, even if you don't train or exercise structurally that day, 10 minutes a day of just working on maintenance. I like foam rolling. I like stretching. I like getting out and doing a couple corrective exercises that you've been working on. Something to move, with this being the focus. Move the needle forward with your recovery and your daily maintenance. And then looking at trying to sleep 8 hours per day, 7.5 if you're really deep diving on the research that has changed in the last 2 months, because humans have evolved that much in the last 2 months. 7.5 to 8 hours is going to be the recommendation. And then finally, one of the most important things is to be able to breathe, meditate, and be mindful for at least 5 minutes per day. And this is really hard for people. People look at it and they're like, man, breathing for 5 minutes? Like, yeah, that's really going to help me. But closing your eyes, being able to be into a parasympathetic positional breath that allows you to centrally downregulate. Whew, man, that is one of the most effective things that I've used for my clients across the board, whether they're athletes or whether they're trying to lose weight. We usually do this right at the tail end of a training session, or we do it before sleeping. And we get down on our backs, we elevate the feet up, we close the eyes, we have a quiet environment, and we try to extend the breath out, usually 6 to 7 seconds on the inhale, 3 to 4 seconds at the top hold, an extended 7 to 8 out on the exhale, and a 3 to 4 hold at the bottom. Doing that for anywhere from 3 to 5 minutes after training, it's literally like you took a supplement that you never thought it existed or worked. Like, it's unbelievable, and it's free. A lot of the things that I did mention here too, it's not any of this high technology stuff. It's not any of the super expensive or sexy things that you're trying to be sold on a Facebook ad. They're things that are free, and they're things that are autonomous. Over the years, I've tried to drive our training systems forward to something that is not dependent on any tool or any anything that costs money. We want to be able to be autonomous with our own body and the way that it moves. So being able to have that with your own body, it's a skill for life, and it's a skill that I wish more people had, and that's the mission that we're on.
I think it's a great formula. That's one I'm going to... It helps to have things like that in terms of a general, I don't know what you call it, but just some general pointers of things that you need to build into your day and week. Like, from a business perspective, I've got those things, you know, when you work with your team, where you yourself, your research and stuff. But from your own body, you've got the basics, but I like the level of detail you went in there, because those are things that you can kind of like plan into your day and allow time and yeah, I suppose get that balance that you need.